Welcome to a video on determinants. This video will show how to calculate determinants for 2x2 and 3x3 matrices. A determinant is a real number associated with a square matrix. So if A is a square matrix as we see here, then the determinant of A can be written like this or with vertical bars like this, and it's equal to AD minus BC. And we actually used this in an earlier video to determine the inverse of a 2x2 matrix. So if this is our matrix A, then we can say that determinant of matrix A, which can be written like this, is equal to negative 8 times 1, that's negative 8, minus negative 3 times 9, which is negative 27. So this is negative 8 plus 27. Which equals 19. So for matrix B, the determinant of B can be written like this or like this. And this is equal to 7 times 4, which is 28, minus 9 times 2, which is 18. So the determinant of matrix B is equal to 10. So it's pretty straightforward for a 2x2. Now there's two methods to calculate the determinant of a 3x3. Method one is called the diagonal method. And this is how it works. We first start by copying the three columns of the matrix, and then we add column one and column two to the end to make a total of five columns. So again, the first three columns are from the original matrix, and then we recopy column one and column two. Once we have it set up in this fashion, we can calculate the determinant of matrix A as follows. Determinant A is equal to the sum of the products of the red diagonals that start at the top and move to the right, minus sum of the product of the green diagonals, which start at the top right and move to the left. So we have the quantity of AEI plus BFG plus CDH minus the quantity of CEG AFH and BDI. Let's go ahead and give this a try. So if we want to find the determinant of matrix A, we'll first copy these first three columns, and then we'll copy the first two columns again. So negative 2, negative 1, 2, and then 2, 1, 0. And we're going to have the sum of three products minus the sum of three products. The first three products will start at the top and move to the right, so we have 1, 2, 3. Let's go ahead and find those products. So we have negative 1 times 1 times negative 1, that's positive 2, plus 2 times 3 times 2, that's 12, plus negative 3 times negative 1 times 0 is 0. And now we'll form the other diagonals that start at the top and move to the left. So we have 1, 2, 3. So let's go ahead and find those products. We have negative 3 times 1 times 2, that's negative 6, plus negative 2 times 3 times 0, that's 0, plus 2 times negative 1 times negative 1, that's positive 2. So it looks like we have 14 minus negative 4, which is equal to 18. The determinant of matrix A is equal to 18. Now let's go ahead and take a look at a second method for determining a 3x3 determinant. It's called the method of cofactors, and this is how it works. To calculate the determinant of a 3x3 matrix, we multiply each element in any row or column by the determinant formed by deleting the row and column of that element. If the sum of the row and column of the element is even, we're going to add the product. And if the sum of the row and column of the element is odd, we will subtract the product. So let's see how this is going to work. We could select any row or column to work with, but let's go ahead and just stick to the first row. So what that rule is telling us is we take this first element, negative 2, and we're going to multiply it by the determinant formed by deleting the row and column of this element. So if we eliminate row 1 and column 1, we're left with these four elements, which form the 2x2 determinant. So we have 1, 3, 0, negative 1. And since this element is in row 1, column 1, and 1 plus 1 equals 2, which is even, we're going to add this product. Now we're going to work our way across row 1. So we just use this element. Now we'll use this element, which is in row 1, column 2. So we'll eliminate row 1, column 2, and we're going to have the element 2 times the determinant that we just formed, so negative 1, 3, and 2, negative 1. Now this element here is in row 1, column 2. 1 plus 2 is 3, which is odd, so we have to subtract this product. And now we have one more element in row 1 we have to work with. And now we're going to have negative 3, this element here, times a determinant formed by deleting the row and column of that element. So the determinant will be negative 1, 1, 2, 0. And then lastly, this is in row 1, column 3. 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. Obviously 4 is even, so we'll add this product. So if we always use the first row, it'll be plus, minus, plus. Let's go ahead and evaluate these 2 by 2 determinants and then find these products. So here we have negative 2 times, this is going to be negative 1 minus 0, it's negative 1, minus 2 times this determinant, which is negative 1 times negative 1, that's 1, minus 6, that's negative 5. Here we have plus and negative 3, it's the same as minus a positive 3 times, here we have negative 1 times 0, that's 0, minus 1 times 2, that's negative 2. Let's go ahead and finish this off. We're going to have positive 2 plus 10 plus 6, which is equal to 18. And I don't know if you noticed, but this is the same matrix that we had before, so of course the determinant should be the same, and in fact it is. So we have two ways of finding a 3 by 3 determinant. It doesn't matter which way you use. I think you have to be a little more careful with this method because based upon what row you choose, it's going to affect whether you'll add or subtract these different products. I hope you found this explanation helpful. Thank you for watching.